by the way.
Our island.
And here he met his wife. He married with a local woman. Her name was Roxana.
Alexander and she's
Roxana.
Roxana.
He met her here in Samarkand. Then in the first century BC, this territory were ruled by Chinese, from Chinese tribes, Kushan Empire. From the first century till the third century, and fourth, it was ruled by Turks. By Turks nowadays. And then by local rulers till the invasion of Chinggis Khan. Chinggis Khan, you also know, right?
Yeah.
Chinggis Khan.
Yeah,
you know. He conquered Samarkand. He destroyed Samarkand. He burned Samarkand.
Why?
He made a big fire.
Why?
Actually, Chinggis Khan by himself, he didn't want to conquer this land. His land was near Mongolia.
Yeah.
He wanted to establish a good trade relationship with local rulers.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, the ruler was not wise here. When he sent ambassadors with a gift to the ruler, he killed them. Second time, Chinggis Khan sent them. Ambassadors again. Then he cut me, destroy everything. So, in 14th century, this is a famous century now, it's a hero, the ruler. It was in time of Timur himself, he was born in Shahrisabz. It's not Samarkand, it's 100 kilometers from Samarkand. He was born in a family. His father was a ruler of a small tribe. His tribe was Barlas. It's mixed Tatar and Mongol. Okay. Then, when he was 35, he became a ruler of Samarkand. And during his time, he conquered 26 countries, including Central Asia, part of India, part of Turkey, part of Gulf area, Egypt, even Sudan, and some Kuwait. He had four sons, but he had 12 wives. And ambassador of Spain at that time, Ruy Gonzalez de Clavijo. He wrote his famous book. You can find it in the library, so you can read the true story about the time of Timur. He said that Timur's family was so open. They were Muslims, but their wives, they wear very beautiful dress and never covers their head. So they were open and even they drank wine. Can you imagine? For each wife under Timur, he built a small garden inside Samarkand. That is why Ruy Gonzalez de Clavijo, he says that Samarkand is a green city, city of garden.
Yeah.
Because everywhere you
see garden.
Today in our program we will visit the grave of Ahmed Timur. He died when he was 69 during his campaign to China.
Okay. Why did he die?
And he died, he was sick, he had lung problems, and he died in the territory of nowadays Kazakhstan. Shahrukh, he became a ruler. You know some Shahrukh?
Yeah, we met someone in the plane.
Okay, this one, Shahrukh. He became a ruler, and he gave Samarkand to his son, Ulugbek. Ulugbek is well known in the world. He is an astronomer. Have you heard about him?
No. I searched about Samarkand.
Yeah.
I read about
him. So, Ulugbek is a great astronomer who calculated the duration of the year and he made a mistake less than 1 minute.
Yeah.
Okay. And he wrote his famous book Zijik Uragani, where he described about stars, about planet, about time, about movement or movement of the planet.
What's his name?
Ulugbek.
Ulugbek.
by the way, this name of this street is Gulubek Street.
What? It's the
street.
It's
Gulubek.
Gulubek.
Gulubek means, in Uzbek, Uluk.
This is great.
Big, big like a prince.
Yeah. Like we know this
Gulubek.
Big. And then the rest is
So, program is we will visit the place where Amir Timur and his son is buried. And after that, we will have lunch. And we will visit the famous square in Uzbekistan, Registan Square. This is like a business card of Uzbekistan. Everywhere you go in the airport, you see the picture with the three buildings. This is Registan. It's like we say that all roads comes to Registan. Take you to the Registan. This one is take you to the Registan.
Become the ruler of Samarkand. He was born out of Samarkand.
He was born in other places. At the age of 25, he became a soldier in the army of the local ruler. Because at that time, this land was under the control of Mongolians, Genghis Khan's son, descendants. Actually, Timur, he couldn't be a ruler. He made the cheating things, killed the ruler, and became. Timur, he never had a title like Khan, like you have Genghis Khan. He was Emir. The granddaughter of Genghis Khan and got a title Kuragan, which means son-in-law of Genghis Khan. He was good as a ruler, but when he was young, he was a military guy.
But his father was a ruler, right?
Yes.
And he didn't inherit his father. He didn't inherit his father's. Shahrukh, he was religious. He didn't like to go for fighting, just was praying in the mosque and thought about the God. The last one, Miran Shah, he had mental disease. And Timur, he didn't want. So he chose his grandson, Muhammad Sultan. He was a son of his first son, Jahangir. And in the end of 14th century, 13th century, here was a complex of Muhammad Sultan, of the grandson of Amir Timur, which consisted of, you see these remains over there, just the bricks. Here was Hanako. Hanako, it is like a hostel for the Sufis. You know who's Sufi, right? Yeah. A hotel for the Sufi, for the religious man who passed Samarkand. This side, you also see the same remains. There was Madrasa. Madrasa in the east, it was religious school, only the religious school. But this madrasa of Muhammad Sultan, they studied religion and military. Okay? For example, this portal, this entrance, also were built in the end of 13th century by Iranian master. It's covered with a mosaic. Mosaic, it is small pieces.
Okay.
I will show, when we go there, I will show you the original part of it, which is 600 years
old.
Okay. Later on, unfortunately, the grandson of Amir Timur, Muhammad Sultan, he died before 2 years, before Timur. So that is why Timur, he ordered to build a mausoleum, the grave itself, for his favorite grandson. Later on, it's this grave yard became a family grave of Timur. Just only men. Women separate.
Okay. The women have their own graveyard too?
Yeah, here. I mean, in time of Timur.
Okay.
So now we're going inside.
We have to remove our shoes?
No. So this is a map of Timur's Empire. What you see with the green color, this is the territory of Amir Timur's country. So as I told you, Amir Timur was born in Shahrizabs, which is here. His first city which he conquered, it was Samarkand, and he made it as a capital. Then his campaign to Central Asia. Then three times he went to conquer Iran. During his campaign, he conquered Baghdad, Caucasus, parts of India, and Turkey, parts of Turkey. His last campaign was to China, where he died in the city Atrar. How he died? Down, and they have the same location like it up. Okay, in the middle, the black grave stone belongs to Amir Timur. This is Nefrit Jade. Nefrit. Okay, stone. But it's look like a black, but when comes the sun shine, it's dark green. Okay, then the big one, green. It belongs to his favorite grandson, Muhammad Sultan. Okay, these two to his two sons, son of Timur, Shahrukh and Mihrinshah. The narrow one belongs to Ulugbek. Who was Ulugbek?
The one who ruled, Shahrukh gave.
Him. Yeah, and he was
religious grandson, Timur's grandson.
Religious
man.
Scientist,
astronomer.
Why he had this title, and before campaign.
never lost. I mean, he always was a winner, wherever he went. Okay. So now look at this trellis. It is original. It's made of marble. Let's talk about the decoration of this mausoleum because it is unique. The construction is has eight corners, octahedral. Okay. Then it goes to the fourth corner. Then the dome. I told you, look at the dome outside with the ribs. Okay, it is out dome. This one, in dome, which dome is inside. The distance between them is 10 meters. And this dome covered with golden leaves and has ornament flower, which means paradise. Okay. Then you see the flowers, vase with the flowers. This is tree of life. Okay. Then we go down. This is inscriptions in Kufi style. You know, Kufi writing, yeah, Kufi written Muhammad many times. Then we go down again. This is the Rome with the Kufi. Writing, Muhammad, down. This is inscriptions from the Quran. And the last panel, it's made of onyx. This is renovated. The old one is over there. Okay?
So originally it's not onyx.
This one is onyx.
What? You can wait. How much can be
The horse tail on the top. It's like protection from the bad spirits. But in army of Chinggis Khan, they used this symbol. If it stood vertical, it means army must be ready to go to fight. The time for preparing and we go for fight. If it was horizontal, means we don't go anywhere. We are in this peace. Questions?
Yes. What made Muhammad Sultan very special? I mean, why was he his favorite.
Because by nature, by character, he was like Amir Timur. Amir Timur, he was a fighter. He was not a religious. He was a Muslim. But his target was to conquer, to take the best thing and bring it to his capital, to Samarkand. Mm. He liked to go and fight. He lived with a war.
Yeah.
He couldn't stay in the peace. But for example, if we compare Muhammad Sultan and Ulugbek, he was a scientist. He went only two times to Azerbaijan, okay, to conquer, and he came back. It's just to show off that I went and I came, and he just worked in science. But Muhammad Sultan, he was like his grandfather, by character, by spirit. Question?
So it's not just placed there, it's from ancient. Okay.
Why is there a difference between all the
differences
between the
graves?
Yeah.
It's government, no meaning, but just the, for example, because they were decorated. The grave of Amir Timur gravestone, it was brought by Ulugbek. He brought this stone from Azerbaijan when he went to Kazdin. He brought these two pieces of stone and he made it classically.
Okay, great. Thank you, Maria.